Welcome to science, week 20. Today we're going to be making a bridge. The next few weeks in science are fun. We're going to be building stuff. So we're going to learn about what designs make the strongest bridges. Parents, I am using from CC Connected, Nicoleum. Again, great resource. It kind of gives you all the information you need, questions you might want to ask, explanations of what we're learning. So, material. You're going to need straws. I believe you all picked up the material from Miss Monica last week, right? So straws, rubber bands to like connect the pieces. If you don't want to use rubber bands, you can use tape. You can use Play-Doh if you want to stick the pieces together. So tape. You may need a scissor. And a couple of books, a couple of sturdy books that you can stand on end so that they can lay their bridge across and test it out. All right. If you have more than one child, they can build in, one between the two of them, or one each. If you want to have them do teams, whatever works. But each group will design your own bridge, and you're going to aim for sturdiness. We want strength in the bridge. How much weight can it carry? Hopefully, if we can get together again in person before this year ends, hang on to your bridges, because then we can have a community-wide contest with the bridges. So that'll be fun. So what have we already learned? If force pushes down on your bridge and your bridge pushes back against that force to hold the weight, which of Newton's three laws is happening? Which one? So it would be Newton's third law, right? For every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. So we can bring those things into your lesson. While they're building their bridges and they can create their own designs, we want them to be, just use their brains, and they can do some research. The master's class, where the kids are kind of older, if they're interested in engineering and building, they can look online and maybe find some patterns or some ideas to do it, or you can just wing it and they can just play around with it and see what they can get to work best. So as they're doing it, we want to, how strong is it? Is it going to be a stronger bridge if it's a shorter bridge? If we put straws together, does that make it stronger? Does it make it weaker? If we put the base of the straws, if we tape two or more straws together, is that making it stronger? If we, add a piece up this way, what's that going to do to it? And you can use coins, anything to put some weight on it and test it out, right? What shape makes them stronger? Bridges, there's a really short, really good video on CC Connected that just kind of explains a little bit about bridges and what types of bridges there are. So that's a really good resource if you want to look at that. Bridges are built over rivers and ravines to help people and cars and trucks cross over safely. Words like compression, when the weight pushes down on the bridge, we call it compression. Under the weight, the bridge feels a stretch called tension. Has to be able to keep from bending or buckling or snapping. That would be bad, right? There's different types of bridges. And on the back of that sheet that I just showed you, it shows you different types of bridges. So your kids can try and create a bridge maybe that's constructed like one of these. We have a beam bridge over here. We have a truss bridge, an arch bridge, and suspension bridges, right? So those different types of bridges, we'll talk about those. I made a little bridge of my own, so I'm actually standing two books up on end, gives it a little bit of height, and just have them play with it. That's my little bridge, right? I just use tape, and I just kind of, put some pieces together to see what happens, right? And if you get some coins or some stones, whatever, and put them on there and see how much weight it can handle, and they can test out the different styles, right? And obviously how much give, right? We don't want our bridge to buckle or to bend. We want it to be sturdy and strong. All right, so that's what we're doing. And just an interesting kind of fun fact, Roman aqueducts are arch bridges, and they're still standing today. So if you build a bridge right, it will withstand the test of time. And that's our lesson for today. Thank you guys. I hope you have a blessed day, and I really hope to see you soon. God bless. Bye.